Hello everyone, I'm back and I'm feeling much better. I had all kind of medical tests and they all came out positive. So that was a big relief for me, and now I'm inspired again to create some art. And in this video you can see me make some flower geode coasters, but also a geode coaster holder. And I'm using different colorants to see what kind of effect I can create with those pigments. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials about resin, like this one, or acrylics, alcohol, ink, and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell, because that way you don't miss anything, and select all, that's very important. And then you don't miss any future videos that I upload to my channel. So, what I already mentioned, I'm going to make some geode coasters again, but also a geode coaster holder. And I already poured the first layer in the holder off camera. But these coasters will get two layers because I want them really thick. So, I'm starting with a black color, and it's the Resin Pro Black Paste. And on the outside, so a very thin line. And I started with a layer of clear resin. In the middle, I'm using an alcohol ink. And this is the Pinata alcohol ink Baya Blue. I want to see what effects I can create with alcohol ink together with pastes. So on top of the clear, I'm pouring in the middle a puddle of the Baya Blue. On top, in the middle, a little bit of clear to push the blue to the outside. And now I'm using again a Pinata alcohol ink, and this is the Signorita Magenta. I think those two colors look great together. So in this video you will see me make the coasters, but also the unmolding, and of course the end result. I always show a close-up of the end result at the end of this video. You will see a close-up of the back and the front, but also the holder. You can already see that the black is bleeding to the middle. Some nice effects. So I don't know if this is going to work, but we will find out together. The heat gun to remove some air bubbles. Again, the Baya Blue on top of the Signorita Magenta. There you can see it. And I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro Resin. I still have a promo code for the Resin Pro company, and in my promo code is Petra. If you use that code, then you get 10% discount on your total order. And it's also now possible for the German site, and I want to thank Barbara especially for that, because she sent them an email that my code didn't work on the German site, so she made it possible that now also my code is you can use my code for the German site, then you can also get 10% discount. So that's great, so thank you so much, Barbara. So in the middle, a mixture of gold leaf and blue iridescent flitter flakes. And I mix these two in a little bit of resin. And on top, I'm also pouring a little bit of resin. And I'm getting some nice effects with the black. Hopefully it doesn't overtake my whole coaster, that it's totally black. But yeah, this is an experiment with different pigments, with alcohol ink and pastes. The rest of the black I'm pouring into the, I don't know the name for it in English, but you put those two things under the holder so that it's not laying flat on your table. Otherwise you can't put your coasters in it. And now I'm using again a white on top of the colors, and this is the Casting Craft white paste, because I know that outside of Europe you can't get the Resin Pro white paste, so that's why I'm going to experiment with this white paste from Casting Craft. It's much easier to buy for you all outside of Europe. So in circles I'm adding the line on top of the colors, and I put the paste in a Ziploc bag and I cut off the tip of the bag, and now I'm pushing the white paste resin out of my Ziploc bag. There you can see it. And I'm going to make my design because I want to have a look of a flower. So I'm dragging with a stick from the outside to the inside. There you can see it. Then you get a nice design. So hopefully this design will stay during drying. Yeah, I'm liking that. So what I already mentioned, I got some rough 4 weeks behind me, and I'm still not totally fit, but I got all medical tests, and they all came out positive, so that was great, and that was a big relief for me. So now I can try to think positive and create some art. So I'm done with the design. Now I'm adding the heat on top of the white lines, not too much. I'm also using my embossing tool, because that embossing tool doesn't get that hot as a heat gun, so that's why I'm using the embossing tool. And I also want to thank everyone that placed a comment under my post. They are really heartwarming, and I appreciate it a lot, so thank you so much for all your nice comments. So the first layer is now done, and now I'm showing you a close-up of my first layer. There you can see the design. It already changed because this is 1 hour later, so the white already sank to the bottom. But I like the design, so hopefully this will stay. And hopefully I also got a nice backside. But yeah, I need to wait for that, because this these coasters will get one more layer. There you can see it. Really nice. I'm very pleased with how it looks now. A little bit closer. Yeah, it's nice. So the first layer is dry now. Now I'm going to start on the geode coaster holder. And I'm adding some cold leaf. I think that will look nice. Because I'm going to use all transparent colors. No, not all. Because I'm also going to use black. But most of the colors are transparent. So you will see the gold leaf through it. And I also want to mention that the coaster holder and the geode coaster silicon molds are from Molds and Shapes. I will put a link in the description box. And if you are interested, you only need to send them a message and then it's all done. So now I'm adding a Bombay ink teal on top of the gold leaf to fill my coaster holder mold to the top. Yeah, and these molds are amazing. They are really good quality. My embossing tool for the air bubbles to remove them. And during drying, my coaster stayed the same. So I'm very pleased with this side. On the outside, I'm adding some black. Again, the black paste of Resin Pro. And I'm also going to add some white. Again, the Casting Craft white. And now I'm using some heat to create some effects. I'm starting again on the coasters. First, I'm pouring some clear in the middle. Because what I already mentioned, I want them thicker. Dus that's why I'm adding first a layer of clear. And no colors in this layer. Because I like the effect that I got on the first layer. So though I don't want to cover it up. Yeah, now again I'm adding some blue iridescent flitter flakes in the middle. And hopefully I can create some depth with this. And more of the clear on top and on the outside. Again, the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. Adding a little bit more of the clear in the Geode coaster holder mold. Because I want to fill it all the way to the top. And then I'm almost done again with the second layer. And then I need to let this dry for 24 hours before I can take them out of the mold. So it's 24 hours later. And now I can take the coasters out of the mold and also the holder. Starting with the first one. That goes very easy. And they look great. This side is amazing. But yeah, how does the back side look? The last one. And now onto the holder. Also that one goes very easy. And I'm going to take a closer look. To the first one. This side is amazing. Yeah, and that's a lot of white, but yeah, you will see it also a close-up in the outside. I'm so sorry for my friends bulldogs, they make a lot of noise. But yeah, then you will see that the light is shining through, so it looks that it has a lot of white, but also that looks great. And that was my friend's bulldog. So now onto the holder. Yeah, you can see I also put some gold leaf on the sides. And this will be the side how you can put your coasters into the holder. There you can see the two things you need to put under your holder, because that way it's lifted from your table. And then you can place them into the holder. So that's great. Yeah, and I'm thinking about making the sides of the coasters gold. I think that will look nice. So here you have a little bit a closer look. And that's the back side. It's also nice. Very different. And there you have the holder. With the gold leaf and a nice sparkle. Yeah, I'm very pleased. So this is a close-up of the front, so how I poured it. I also made the sides gold. And yeah, I think that looks really nice. There you can see the light shining through. So this is the side how I poured it into the mold. And I'm very pleased how this side looks. I think it looks amazing. So let me know what you think of these coasters, which side you prefer, or maybe you like both, or not at all. That's also possible. But I like this side a lot. It's really nice. Now you can see the light shining through a little bit closer. But it's so difficult to film this. But I do my best. Yeah, and this is a close-up of the backside. I also like this, but I prefer the front. But this is a totally different effect. Also nice. There you can see it. But what I wanted to do is to use different pigments to see if I could also create this effect and then not using the Resin Pro white paste. So you can also do this with the white Casting Craft paste, so that's great, and also using alcohol ink. So my experiment, I think it was a success to show you all that it's also possible if you use other materials. And this is a close-up of the coaster holder. Very nice. Also very pleased with this one. I especially like the sparkle and of course the gold leaf. So I think it looks amazing. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because then you don't miss any videos that I upload to my channel. All the links to the websites are in the description box, also to the silicone molds. And I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye!